What's up, guys? So in this video, I'm going to teach you exactly how I use Phrase to do my on-page SEO. And this is a really powerful tool that you can use to start doing most of the hard work when it comes to on-page SEO. In fact, I pretty much optimize all the pages on most of my websites using this tool. And as you can see, it's driving over 30,000 visits just to one of my pages simply by following the on-page optimization methods they recommend. So if you want a powerful tool that teaches you exactly how to do your on-page SEO and do most of the heavy lifting for you, then make sure you watch this video. Okay, so once you're on phrase.io, what you want to do is sign up for a free account here. I actually use a paid account, but if you just want to check it out for free, then you can do that by clicking here. And once you're logged in, you'll see your main Phrase feed that looks like this. So what we're going to do is click on new document over here. And from here, what I'd recommend is if you're creating a new piece of content, click this. If you're optimizing an existing piece of content, then you can click over there. Now for this video, I'm just going to work on a completely new piece of content and we can see how it goes. So let's say we want to talk about the best camping gear. Right? What you can do is create a document over here. And from here, Phrase is going to start importing and looking at all the data around your competitors. So essentially, Phrase looks at all your competitors. It looks who's ranking, you know, top 10 on Google. And then it starts to create all the data and all the recommendations around that. Now, it might take a couple of minutes to load, so I'm just going to wait for this to load and then come back to you. All right, so I've waited a couple of minutes and Phrase has delivered all the data that I was looking for here. So we're back in the game, and now you can see on the right-hand panel that Phrase has basically analyzed all of our top 10 competitors, which you can actually edit here. So if you want to exclude any, just click edit and then uncheck the competitors you don't want to include. And then on the right panel, you can see all these recommendations in terms of what you should change on your page or what you should include on your page to make sure that you rank like your competitors. So you can see, for example, here, the average word count across our competitors is 2,500. Okay, so we should probably aim for around 2,500 words. 8 headers are included, 16 links are included within the article, so they could be internal links, for example. And then the average is 65 images, which is pretty damn high, actually. Quite a surprise here. So as we scroll down, we can see what headers our competitors have included. So for example, they've got a H1 header here, and then you can see they've included H3 tags underneath. So under each of our competitors, we get a breakdown of the headers, the header they've used, what sort of topics they've covered in the article, that sort of thing. So it's quite useful information. It saves you a lot of manual time and frustration going for all your competitors because pretty much all the data that you need is already analyzed here. And then if we click onto headers over here, you can see what sort of headers our competitors have used. And then also what sort of links have been included in the article too. So the content that's highlighted in yellow here, these are the links that are used within the Phrase article. And then there's also going to be like some statistics here. So like, you know, for example, if you want to include some references in your article to make it look well researched, well, these are some of the facts that have been included by your competitors. Now, what you can actually do is automate your whole content brief, okay? So if you've ever tried to create a content brief, you know that it takes a long time. But if you want to outsource your content, you need to create a content brief and some sort of guidelines and instructions for your writers to use so they can start writing your content. So Phrase pretty much automates most of this. So you can include guidelines here, what people also ask, so related questions asked on Google, the most commonly used topics from your competitors, relevant headers that your writers could use, any sort of questions that they could cover, and even some statistics, right? So if you click on Insert Brief into Editor, what Phrase is going to do is automate most of this. So this is a brief that your writer can then just take and start writing your content, right? And as you scroll down, it's automatically filled in all the information that your writer needs, right? So if they're not sure what to write about, for example, you've got the main topics here and also the main headers as well. So it's a really useful tool. Now, obviously, if you're going to structure the article, this isn't like the perfect structure. Obviously, most of these headers are pretty similar. So what you might want to do is insert a structure section underneath that tells your writer exactly in what order to write the content. So like what they're going to write in the first header, the second header, etc. And then once you've done this and you've completed, you know, your goal, your target audience, the deadline, etc., you can actually click export, share link, editable. And this will create an editable version of your content brief that you can give to your writers, and then they can start filling in the information. It usually takes a couple of minutes to load. But yeah, that's a really useful tool. And then from there, your writer can just go in and start writing the content. And as they write in the content, you can actually see like a topic score. So Phrase is going to grade the content in terms of how well optimized it is. Maybe by the keywords that you've included, the headers, the questions, etc. So you're going to get a topic score, which is super useful. Now, the only thing is that if you scroll through these, you don't want your writer to sort of create a piece of content that reads like a robot has written it. So if they don't hit like 100% of all of these keywords, it's not a big problem, okay? You don't need to be like OCD on this. These are just rough guidelines to make sure that your content is hitting the right sort of topics and keywords for your article, but it doesn't need to be perfect. For example, you know, if your content writer starts trying to include like all the keywords in this list, then it's probably not going to read very natural. So there has to be a balance there. And then next up, you've got the commonly asked questions. Now, this is quite cool because you can see what's commonly asked on Google. So Phrase will load a people also ask section, and you can see the top questions here. But then also you can see, okay, if people are searching this topic on Quora, what sort of questions are they asking? And you know, you can see related to the best camping gear, they're asking like, what are some of the best camping gadgets and tools? What's the best brand for camping products? What's the best store to buy camping and fishing equipment? So there's loads of topic ideas, loads of FAQ ideas that are going to be super useful. And the same for Reddit. It pretty much feeds in the main FAQs that are asked on Reddit around this particular keyword. So that's going to save you potentially hours of hard work and research. And that's what I love about this tool. It sort of feeds in most of the information for you. And then also if you click on related, this is going to find related articles that you could use as inspiration in your article. Now, if you're giving this to a writer, it's quite useful because then your writers can click on these links and they can see, okay, how have other people written about similar topics? So super useful. Instead of you going in and manually copying and pasting every single link into the content brief in terms of competitors, you've got all the data on the right-hand panel. So yeah, super useful. Same for news and same for Wikipedia too. Now, what's also quite useful with Phrase is that you can go to new document here and then you can start optimizing existing articles too. So once this loads, you can click on optimize existing content like this, import the URL, import the keyword too, and then create the document. What that's going to do is analyze your existing content on this page in terms of how well optimized is it and are there any ways you can improve it. And it's going to compare your existing content versus your competitors' ranking on Google. And you can see here the topic score is 100%, so that's pretty good. But there's still a lot of keywords that I've actually overused in the article. So, and also some that I've missed out completely, you know, for example, like scientists. But again, these aren't perfect. Like, scientists is not that closely related to beautiful birds, and therefore that's probably why I didn't include it. And again, it'll give you ideas on questions, that sort of thing. So, you know, everything that you need to re-optimize your content is here. And what you could also do is just edit your content based on the topics and the results, and then, you know, copy and paste that straight into WordPress. So it's a super useful tool in terms of optimizing your existing content and creating new content too. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope this video helped you. You should now know how to use Phrase to do your on-page SEO. Now, the thing is, when it comes to on-page SEO, it's incredibly useful for your site. But if you really want to rank your site, you still need backlinks. Now, I actually have an agency, a link building agency, that helps my clients build backlinks to their site and increase their rankings and drive more organic traffic. So if you're interested, feel free to go to juliangoldie.com and schedule in a call, and I'll be happy to help you. We can have a conversation about how to grow your site with link building and SEO. So thanks for watching, guys.